Today, I'll take you on a nostalgic journey as we hop aboard a crowded 40-year-old electric multiple unit bound for El Jadida, a charming tourist destination near Casablanca. I'll take you through the bustling stations, briefly show you the vintage train, and immerse you in the scenery, all while highlighting just how affordable this day trip from Casablanca can be. Come along! Marhaban, bikum fit dar al-Bayda. Hi and welcome to Casa-Port, the secondary railway station in Casablanca and from where several local and regional trains depart to destinations such as the airport or El Jadida, our destination for today's trip. Similar to Casa-Voyageurs, this station was recently fully modernized, bringing it up to par with modern European train stations. I wasn't sure about whether to post this video, but in the end, I decided to go for it and show you this short trip. Why? Well, first of all, it gives me the chance to feature Casa-Port on the channel. Secondly, it's a journey on a train that won't be available for much longer. And lastly, it provides a realistic portrayal of traveling on short-distance Moroccan trains. Even though it's a bit different from my usual videos, I hope you enjoy it. For now, and before exiting to the platforms, a little snack. After passing tickets control, I'm able to reach the platforms on time to film the arrival of our train for today, composed of two ZMC electric multiple units, one recently modernized and the other still in the old ONCF livery. In 1982, ONCF ordered 8 of these units, very similar to the Belgium AM80 brake, for fast services between Casablanca and Rabat. They entered service in late 1983 and proved so successful and reliable that ONCF ended up ordering 6 more, which entered service in 1992. Nowadays, they are used mostly from Casa-Port to El Jadida, but can also be seen occasionally at Casablanca's Mohammed V airport. Last year, ONCF launched the tender for 168 new trains for a wide range of services, from which some will most likely replace these aging but strong units. Not knowing if this will be my last opportunity to show the Moroccan ZMCs on the channel, I choose to publish this video anyway, even if it differs a little from my usual one. The departure is scheduled for 12:30 PM, but there is a 10-minute delay due to the high number of passengers using this service, and we end up departing at 12:40. As I have mentioned in my previous videos about Morocco, trains are extremely popular here. Today's service is no exception, as the train is already nearly at capacity when departing Casa-Port. Here, just like all the stations I visited in Morocco, everything is very clean and well kept. Departure is also the moment when I show you the map for today's trip. It's short and simple, 113 km from Casa-Port to El Jadida, stopping at Casa-Voyageurs and a few other stations along the way, at a maximum speed of 160 km per hour. Already passing the sidings adjacent to Casa-Voyageurs, an Al-Boraq high-speed unit can be seen in all its beauty and glory. Check my video traveling in one of these sets from Casablanca to Tangiers. Our first stop is Casa-Voyageurs, where the train becomes extremely crowded, the reason why I can't show you the train's interior. It's important to note that seat reservations are not available for these services, so people end up standing during the journey. It's a short stop, and soon we are moving again to our third stop in Casablanca, Casa-Oasis. On the way, we pass non-stop through immerse Sultan. Casa-Oasis is located in the southern part of Casablanca. Today, all local and long-distance trains stop here in an effort to better serve this area and to alleviate congestion at Casa-Voyageurs. The station is also connected to Casablanca's tramway Line 1. Throughout the years, it became an important part of Casablanca's public transport network. Underway again, it's a good time to talk about prices for this trip. It cost me 55 Moroccan dirham for a first class ticket, bought around 2 weeks in advance. I'm not sure, however, that there's any significant difference between the first and second classes. Bouskura is our last stop in the main line from Casablanca to Marrakech, featured in a recent video here on the channel. Shortly after this station, two lines branch off the main, one to the airport, which is nearby, and another to the west, to El Jadida and the port of George Lasfar. As we speed along the tracks, I'd like to share my thoughts on today's journey. Despite being 40 years old, the ZMC electric multiple units still provide a decent level of service. The ride quality is acceptable, and although they are louder than modern trains, it's not too bothersome. The trip itself was quick, with delays on departure and arrival due to the high number of passengers traveling to this coastal city on a summer afternoon. Overall, I'm enjoying the trip and would definitely choose the train again if I need to travel to the area. At 14:12, with a 7-minute delay, we arrive at our destination, El Jadida. All the passengers on the platform are waiting for us to quickly disembark so they can board the train for the journey back to Casablanca. This route is, indeed, very crowded. Before alighting, I'm able to show you the seat in which I traveled the last hour and a half. The maximum I was able to film of this train's interior. As we pass by the station's cat, being careful not to disturb his rest, I want to express my gratitude for joining me on this journey. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to my channel and leave a comment below. Your support is incredibly helpful and means a lot. Thank you for being here, and see you next week!